Okay, before I get to this video, I want you guys to just take a look at this environment that I'm in. Look at this. Beautiful water. Not too wavy. We got some boats going by bringing some waves over here. But your boy has decent balance, so I think I'm going to be straight. But look at this, man. Look at this. We got the beach over here. And it's literally, you want to talk about the definition of a vibe. It's a vibe out here. It's a beautiful day. Absolute beautiful day out here. On the paddleboard, I'll show you guys. We got a big boy paddleboard. Got my little supply stuff right here. My glasses in case my eyes do get sunburned or on the way back. In this bag, everything is waterproof. So if I do take a spill, pun intended, I'll be good there. Lionels Adventures. And big shout out to him. This board is pretty dope. I'm really excited. I'm a big guy and I need a big board. So yeah. But anyways, let's get into the video, man, because I'm really excited to kind of chat about this for a few minutes because I don't even know what time it is, but I know I ate like an hour and a half ago. And I got to eat in an hour. I got about a 20-minute drive home. So, and I got to paddle back to shore. So we're not going to be out here for too long. But welcome to the channel. Welcome to Reading Between the Lines. I'm your host, Brandon. And this is a channel where we talk about books and things of that nature. For all new subscribers or new visitors, thank you for stopping by again. Thank you for checking this video out. And thank you to the current subscribers and current supporters for sticking around the channel and constantly coming back and providing feedback and just being awesome and being part of the squad that reads between the lines. So thank you. Hit that subscribe button if you want to join that squad. It's awesome here. We vibe out and, you know, we just do our thing. We talk and we learn and we grow and execute and things of that nature. As you read in the title today, 12 Rules for Life by Jordan Peterson. Each rule is going to be a video. So we have a series going on right now. We got the first two videos up. I just did one the other day. You can check those out. I'll put them in the cards and I'll put them down in the description below if you want to check them out. I've gotten some good feedback. I'm really glad that it's at least helping a few people. I'm just trying to get these ideas out to the people who haven't heard of them or even to the people who have heard of these but maybe need a reminder or a refresher or something. So that's the whole point of the series. So hopefully one person, two people, 1,000 people, 1,000,000 people can see this video and just hear this concept or hear these concepts and apply them to their life. So yes, let's get into the discussion. 12 Rules for Life by Jordan Peterson. Today we're talking about rule number 3, and that rule is make friends with people who want the best for you. And it's something I'm figuring out is absolutely crucial. And I want to be clear on my definition of when someone says make friends with someone who wants the best for you. Someone who wants the best for you is someone who knows who you are, your desires, your passions, your goals, the things you want to achieve, and they push you towards those things. The opposite side of the coin for this thing, or for this idea, is people putting their ideas onto you because it may have worked for them, or it may be a society thing. And that part, that's something I fell into, right? Now, when I fell into these, into that side of things where people were putting their ideas onto me because they thought it'd be best for me, it probably wasn't a malicious intent. It's probably just some sort of, I don't know, some sort of programming or thought that they grew up with where it's like, okay, if this works for me, it must work for everybody. And that's fine. I'm not mad about it. You know, it led to a lot of great experiences, a lot of life learning, and I'm super grateful for it. But at the same time, I'm also at the point of awareness where I know that that's not a healthy way of living when you're just doing things because other people do them or because they've worked for somebody else. Now, if someone does come across and say, listen, this has worked for me, it seems like you might benefit from this, feel free to try it. That's a whole different story. We can talk about that for an hour. My main thing that I'm figuring out right now is I'm around people right now that literally only care, like when it comes to me and my goals, they only care about the things that I care about for me. Like, if that makes sense. Like no one's pushing their ideas onto me. But I'm slowly learning that I only have the mental space in my life for the people who want me to succeed in the things that I want to succeed in. Me and Lionel, Lionels Adventures, we talked about this the other day, like 2 days ago. Basically, what he was saying was, if someone doesn't want to provide that value to me or accept the value that I can provide to them for what they want to do, what's the point of me giving my energy, giving anything to this person? Like, there's no point in it because I'm not going to benefit. He's not going to benefit. She's not going to benefit. They're not going to benefit. Whatever. That's kind of the stage I'm at, where it's just like, why give into any kind of thought that says, hey man, what you're doing is stupid. Don't do it. Why would I do that? Like, it's just a complete waste of my time. Because not only am I going to start resenting somebody who is against what I'm doing, but I'm going to start being angry with myself. And this is something I've experienced within bodybuilding and fitness and all this stuff. But nonetheless, man, I'm just really excited to be down here. And just like I said, like having the friends support me for the way I want to be supported, or in the way I want to be supported and all that. As you go through life, consider all of what I'm saying to be a reality. Consider only becoming friends and using your mental space to kind of give to people who actually want the best for you. You know what I mean? All right, so I actually just had to paddle back in more towards shore. I started floating out way out there. And I was getting a little close to boats, and I wasn't trying to get run over. But I don't even know where I left off at. So I'll just kind of rewind a little bit. Having those people who want the best for you in the way that is gonna work for you, not that's gonna work for society or their own minds or whatever, that's the people you need to surround yourself with. Because I hear Joe Rogan and other people say that, think of your mind like the amount of space you have on your phone, right? Like you have a 16 gig phone, 40 gig phone, 100 gig, 128, 256, whatever it is. There's only so much space that you have to operate within your mind. So, you know, if you have a YouTube channel, you put 10 gigs of that, 10 gigs of your energy towards that, right? And now you have, we'll say 100 gigs total, so now you have 90 gigs left. You put 20 gigs into your relationships every week. You put another 20 gigs into, for me, you know, working out, another 20 gigs into eating, right? And now you're only left with X amount of memory, X amount of energy. Why give that to something or somebody who doesn't want the best for you or doesn't care for the best for you, you know? I have had people push ideas onto me, no matter what I thought, no matter what. It was just like, here, Brandon, and it's just like shoving it down my throat, and no matter what, you gotta do this, you gotta do this, you gotta do this. And I did it for a while. I did it for a long time for a lot of different people. And again, I talked about this in the Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck review. I'm probably gonna keep mentioning that book throughout all of these videos, so you can check that out in the cards. I'll put it down in the description below. And I just gave a fuck about all the wrong things. And right now we're talking about relationships with people and friendships and whatnot. And I put too much energy towards the wrong ones. And some of those wrong ones were the right ones before. And then I started growing, and then, you know, things happen, life happens, and then you kind of, people just take different routes. And that's kind of the way things go. And that's what happened, and that's what led me to be down here where I'm at right now, and to be linked up with Lionel and all the people that I'm working with down here. And the really cool thing that I'm really, really grateful for, and side note, this isn't me shitting on anybody. This isn't me saying, oh, F you because you did this or whatever. Because I personally don't believe that everything that was done to me was done with malicious intent. I think it was just done out of like, I think this is the best, and that's kind of where the thought process stops. So this is me saying thank you to all those people out there who told me something to do and helped me figure out that I don't want to do that. This is me being grateful for all of the things that have happened to me, both negative and positive. So I'm super grateful because it's put me in this mindset to where I'm at right now. But anyways, the people that I'm with down here, I'm also really, really grateful for, because these are the people that are pushing me, literally pushing me on my path to the things I want to succeed with business, with fitness, with my relationships, with my mental game, my spirituality. Every single person that's in my life that I communicate with on a day-to-day basis is doing nothing but saying, hey, Brandon, get back on track, man. You got things to do. The amount of energy that simply comes from that is outrageous, like in the most positive way possible. This is the spot for me personally, the things I want to achieve. Me, right? You're gonna be different. Your goals are gonna be different than mine. Your goals are gonna be different than your sisters, your brothers, or your mothers, most likely. And you just gotta find that spot in those people who continuously say, this is the way that you gotta do it, Brandon, right? Maybe not that direct, but like, yo, listen, here's some tips, here's some suggestions to help you proceed and excel and do great on your path. Because having someone to push you is one thing, but having someone to push you while you're on your path is a whole other freaking story, man. And again, you can take my word for it, just because like I said, I'm experiencing this right now, literally right now, on this board, hanging out here. Like I told Lionel about this idea, and I was like, bro, I think I want to just kind of want to take it literally out of the ordinary and go outside and film something on the water. And he's like, bro, take my board. And I was like, what are you talking about? And he's like, yeah, take my board. Like, I don't got to like pay you. I'm going to rent it from you. He's like, no, bro, this is like, if that's what you want to do, right? If this is part of your goals, this is part of your process, if this is something you want to do, and I have the tools and I have the means necessary to help you achieve that, let's do it. So this is like the perfect segue. And I don't know what book it's going to be, but me and Lionel are going to sit down. It's going to be a podcast style. It's going to go on this channel. I'm not sure when or what book or where we're going to do it. Same thing with TJ, my buddy TJ, Savage Average Coaching. I keep bringing him up. And even his brother, Underdog Books, his name is Mike. If you've been around the channel, you know who these three people are. And these three people, man, no matter where the situation is at, they're always thinking, yo, Brandon, you good? All right, cool, man. Let's keep it going. So I'll say it one more time. It's one thing to be pushed and to be motivated, not even motivated, but to be like inspired by someone's words or to be in this constant state of like, wow, man, this guy wants the best for me. But it's another thing to know when someone is pushing that for you, pushing that, giving you that energy for you to go chase the things you want to chase. And I think I went off on a tangent, but I also think that it was a quality one people can get something out of. Yeah, so definitely listen to that. Definitely listen to that chapter. I'm kind of in a state of awe right now for some reason. I don't know. Like, it just hit me right now. Like, me being out here on this water, and like, I got goosebumps all over my body. I have no idea why. Absolutely no idea why. All my thoughts are gone. this feeling that I'm feeling right now. I mean, it's a good one. It's one of those things where, I guess, where you're doing something and it just feels right. But anyways, I really, really, really hope some of this video made sense. I gotta get back in because I gotta go get my meal going because, you know, we got a bodybuilding show coming up. And didn't mean to flex on the camera, but I had to do that for Lionel because Lionel's always flexing rip lips, that's his hashtag. So the long story short, make friends with people who want the best for you. Find those people who want you to succeed for you, not to succeed for them or their ideas or their whatever they think is correct, the best way, whatever, or to conform to society. This is all about breaking the mold and doing the things that you want to do, and then having that support group, to have that tiny circle support you in the way that best benefits you. Finding those friends is not easy, and you going out to search for them might not be easy either. You know, it might be, that process might take a long time, and it might not even happen. Because from my experience, everyone that has come into my life and influenced me in some fashion has just been by happenstance. And it's things you never expect, but when it happens, you know it. Like when you, if you're open to awareness and you're open to like not suggestions, but you're open to possibilities being real and all that stuff. So like, just really, really just keep your eyes open, you know? Keep doing you, don't be leached off of. Don't let people come in and suck all the energy away from you, because again, what's the point? There's literally no point in that. You're going to end up with a lot of resentment, a lot of negativity. It's literally just adding fuel to the worst fire possible in regards to you chasing what you want to chase. And again, I'm really grateful for all the things that have happened to me. I'm grateful that I can share my stories with however many people watch these videos. And I just really want to be authentic and kind of transparent with how these rules are kind of playing out and how I'm learning from them. So with all that being said, that's a wrap for this video. I'm going to go ahead and paddle back to shore. Like I said, I got to get back to my truck. Get some water because I got cottonmouth right now. I also got to get back home and get my food in because I can't not eat. So Lionel, again, dog, I appreciate you letting me come out here, use your paddleboard, lionstailadventures.com, best fishing charter in Destin. But I'll put all that stuff down in the link below. I mentioned TJ, I mentioned his brother Mike. Their stuff is always down below because that's part of the squad right now, part of the growth squad, I guess you can call it. So check them out, check the podcast out. Mike and TJ do some podcasts. TJ has a coaching, or not coaching, more of a fitness-based one. He's a very smart guy. Mike has one as well, but more towards books because that's like what he's about. So check them out, man. They're awesome people. Go support them as well. If you love to learn and stuff like this, you're gonna love all three of them. If you like this video, if it made any sense to you at all, because again, I don't know if it did. It made sense to me because it came from here, but hopefully it made sense to you guys. Give the video a big thumbs up. Helps with the YouTube algorithm and all that good stuff. But if you didn't like it, then you know I'm not gonna push the like button on you. If you wanna have a conversation, per usual, drop a comment down below. I would love to chat about these ideas. Again, I just love conversing and love seeing people be affected in a positive way through these ideas. So let's have a chat about it. And again, if you don't want to talk to me about it, talk to your loved ones, your family members, your friends, whoever, your dog, write in your journal, whatever. But you know, just get out there and get these thoughts written down. And lastly, subscribe if you aren't already. Join the squad that reads between the lines. Like I said, this is a channel where we talk about books and things of that nature, and it's all about growth. It's all about attaining a better mindset, you know, learning and execution, and more learning and more growth and more execution. I said this in my last video. So with all that being said, I'm done rambling, and I'm gonna get this paddleboard back in there. Hopefully I don't take a spill. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.